Assalamu alaikum. Peace be with you. Welcome to our first Ramadan gathering organized by Bonny and Bethany Elementary parents. The children of Bonny and Bethany Elementary will present a short program for you before we break fast tonight at 8:53. We will start our program with Arham and Adam reciting the first passage from the Holy Quran called Fatiha, the opening.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. This means, peace be upon you, when Muslims greet each other. I hope you're all having a good day. My name is Yasin, a fourth grader from Bonny. Today, I'll be talking about Ramadan. I have four key points. What is Ramadan? Breaking fast, celebration, and challenges I face fasting in school. First of all, I'd like to begin with what is Ramadan? Ramadan is the ninth month of the lunar calendar. We know Ramadan begins when we see a thin crescent moon, and the next day we will fast. Fasting means not eating or drinking from sunrise to sunset. Muslims can eat a small meal called suhoor before they fast. We do fasting in Ramadan for two major reasons. One, to feel how the poor people feel, and two, to gain patience. Second of all, I'd like to talk about breaking the fast. The meal where we break our fast is called Iftar. Iftar is really good. We usually start off with a date and milk, just like our Prophet did. We come back and pray, and then we eat a lot. A few hours after Iftar, Muslims come together, form a community, and pray. We pray Tarawih, which is a special prayer, and we pray a lot. Third of all, I'd like to talk about the celebration. The celebration after Ramadan is called Eid al-Fitr, meaning Festival of Breaking Fast. We do this to celebrate the last month we just fasted. We know Eid al-Fitr begins when we see a thin crescent moon, and the next day is Eid al-Fitr. We usually start off Eid with a prayer where we all come together, and then we party a lot, we eat a lot of food, we go to other people's houses, and Eid is probably the best time of the year for me, because one, I gotta skip school. And two, I get many gifts, like many of you do if you celebrate Christmas. And lastly, I'd like to talk about the challenges I face fasting in school. In school, we have to exercise, like in recess or PE. These things are the best parts of school. And whenever I have to run or do activities, I get hungry and thirsty. I still do these anyway. And also, when my classmates bring food and water, whenever I look at it, this makes me hungry or thirsty. So sometimes during lunch, me and my other Muslim friends go to the office to not look at their food. These are challenges I face fasting in school. Before I conclude my speech, I'd like to talk about me and Ramadan. This year, my goal is to fast 28 days out of the 30, and I already missed two, so that means if I want to accomplish my goal, I'll have to fast the rest of the Ramadan. Also, for Ramadan, me and my friends have a lot of sleepovers, and I have a sleepover tomorrow. And also for one suhoor, the meal before we fast, me and my family went to IHOP and we ate pancakes at like 1:30 a.m. It was really good. All in all, I hope I informed you about Ramadan and the challenges I face. If you have any questions, please ask.
We would like to thank you all for attending our gathering, and we hope you enjoy the meal. Please feel free to ask us or our parents any questions.
It is now 8:30, and so we still have 23 more minutes to spare. We were wondering if you guys have any questions. Okay, so then would any of the principals like to come up and say something?
On behalf of Bonny Slope and Bethany, right? I would just like to say that this means so much to us. You know that special room in the school, it's called the staff room, that kids aren't allowed in? Well, we've been talking a lot about coming and how excited we are. And I want you to know from the bottom of my heart and among all of our staff that we want to thank you and tell you how much we appreciate you sharing all about Ramadan with us.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Okay.
Yeah, another.
principle is